at Lyons Township High School for tonight's West Suburban Conference Silver Division matchup, pitting the Panthers of Proviso West High School and the Lions of LT. Sean, tonight the Lions come into the matchup after having disposed of Hinsdale Central, and the Panthers have a record of 5-0. Now this team finished second in the West Suburban Conference last year, but they lost four starters. How's the team look?
Well, Mike, they look great this year. They lost Anthony Knox, their center, who led the conference last season in rebounding and shot blocking. They come right back with a strong center, Telly Lowry. They also come back with a strong perimeter game. They have a brother group going, two twins, Dwayne and Luane Vaughn. And also they have Eric Goodman, a forward, great scoring team.
Now, the Panthers really utilize a tough man-to-man defense that's usually extended to full court. And in order for the Lions to be successful, they're really going to have to utilize their height advantage, especially from Dennis Carroll, who went 7-for-7 against Hinsdale Central.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. Steve Davis, Dennis Carroll have to be active down low because they have the size advantage. They did throughout the season against many teams, and they're going to have it again tonight. But also a key, Litke and Korinsky along the perimeter have to step up on defense and keep going with that good pressure on defense against a good scoring game that the Panthers have. They can run with the best of them down the floor.
Well, the matchup should be a good one. The Lions are ranked number 14 and the Panthers number 16 in the state. So you won't find a much better basketball game at the high school level, and we'll be back with all the action right after this.
Boy, I really did it last night. Got drunk, acted stupid, went home with who is that? What am I, stupid? How did I do this? Barry began to worry, really worry. What about AIDS? Then he remembered, hey, I'm just a cartoon. I don't even have to shower. Get high, get stupid, get AIDS.
The starting lineup for the Lions of Lyons Township High School. At one forward, number 24, 6 foot, 4 inch, junior Dennis Carroll. At the other forward, number 5, 6 foot, junior Mike Warkentine. At the center position, number 40, 6 foot, 8 inches, senior Captain Steve Davis. At one guard, number 4, 6 foot, 2 inches, senior Steve Litke. At the other guard, number 11, 5 foot, 11 inches, senior Chris Korinsky. The Lions are coached by Mr. Ron Nikovich and assisted by Mr. John King. The officials for tonight's contest are Mr. Tom Huster and Mr. Connie Peer.
Warkentine open at the forward positions. Korinsky and Litke once again start at the guards, and Davis in the middle, of course, the captain. For the Panthers, Goodman and Connor will start at forwards. Lowry in the middle with Vaughn and Morrison at the guards. And so now Connor and Davis set to jump and get things underway.
Right off the bat, it's going to be interesting to see how the Panthers can establish that inside game going down low against the Lions, who have that size advantage that we mentioned up top on our show.
Pass deflected and knocked out of bounds. It'll go LT's way. So the first turnover by the Panthers.
Lions ball out of bounds.
Leads to an LT possession.
And that's a good start, Mike, that the Lions want to have. They want to put the heat on the Panthers because this is a team that can run with the best of them. They can score with the best of them. They can shoot well.
Korinsky lost the ball off his foot, and it'll go the other way. So now Morrison works it off the right wing. Dribbles baseline, now the pass inside. LT comes out in kind of a zone man-to-man. And we'll have a foul down low. I think they're going to get Dennis Carroll in this one. It'll be his first. Carroll, of course, was 7-for-7 in the game against Hinsdale Central.
Fouls on Lions, Mike Warkentine.
But you have to give credit, though, to the Panthers right away. Coach Mark Schneider wants to go down low, push it down low. They're not intimidated by the Lions' size advantage.
Panthers work around the perimeter, has pass deflected. Look at the block by Davis. Foul inside will be on Steve Litke, his first of the game. Litke, the Lions' best free throw shooter this season, this far.
Steve Litke, first personal foul, second team foul.
There you go, Telly Lowry. He is the big man to watch tonight, definitely for the Panthers side. He's a big inside scorer, good shot blocker. He's good defensively. He's the
biggest as they come for the Panthers tonight. Stands at 6'6", 190, the senior center.
So Lowry hits the second of the pair, and it's a 1-0 lead. We played almost 1 minute of action here in the first quarter at Lyons Township High School. The lead is 1-0 for the Panthers.
Panthers coming right out with that press. They're not as big as they were last year. They lost Anthony Knox, who was around 6'8", 6'9", but they're very quick, though. They can move real fast defensively.
Workington tried to dish it off to Davis. It was knocked out of bounds, and the Panthers will have the ball. It's now Morrison set to set up the Panther offense amid LT pressure. Vaughn now gives free throw line. Morrison works off the right wing. Pull-up jumper on the way. Missed it right, and the rebound is corralled by Steve Lidke. Long throw ahead pass now to Karinsky. Had Lowry to deal with, and they'll call a foul on Lowry, his first.
Litke's got the good ball movement. He knows where everybody's out on the floor. Good peripheral vision. Right away off the rebound, gets it down court. Chris Karinsky going strong to the hoop. You got to have some good passes from Lidke tonight if you're going to have more success on offense against the Panthers defense.
The Panthers are a deep team, and they have a good bench strength, especially in the front court. So the foul on Lowry isn't all that big if he gets in foul trouble. Karinsky misses his first free throw of the game. It's still 1-0 Panther advantage.
And Karinsky, one of the best defensive players on this team, and they have to look for him for some senior leadership, not only defensively, but if he could drive to the hoop tonight, because that's going to be needed against the backcourt against Proviso.
So both teams come out even here so far. Now Morrison.
All evened up, one apiece. Lyons in a good state of mind right here to start off the ball game. Nothing slipping away so far. Proviso West in a good state of mind.
LT comes away with the rebound after Proviso West had two attempts. Now Morrison comes away with the steal off the Vaughn tip. So Morrison having trouble, finds inside two. Well, there's going to be a foul on.
It's on the Panthers, Mike, and right down low. They caught the inside player pushing off there. Ramil Connor, the center, power forward type player for the Panthers.
So we played 2 minutes, and Connor has his first foul. So two team fouls on the Panthers, and we're all even up here. Karinsky now throw ahead pass to Lidke, who works off the left wing. Now he's going to try to drive baseline and works off a Carroll screen. Top of the key is Karinsky, dribbles left and finds Dennis Carroll on the left baseline. Now Steve Lidke and Karinsky, and they'll work it from the perimeter. They'll work it from the right side now. Workington fakes the jumper, passes it outside, top of the key to Lidke, who works off a Davis screen now on the mismatch. Pull-up jumper on the way from the right baseline and in. So Steve Davis has the first conventional field goal of the game, and it's a 3-1 lead with 5.5 minutes left in the first period.
Nice, tough shot by the senior there. The Lions are going to have to work hard for every basket they get. That is just a good quickness you saw on defense by Proviso.
Morrison's three-pointer came up short, and it'll come the other way for the Lions. Good move that time by Workington to slow things down. He'll give it to Steve Lidke, who led the conference in assists last year. Lidke hits again, and so he's off to a good start. Has right. Four, and the Lions' lead is up to four.
Coming right off the bat, starting off, leading the scoring for the Lions, just taking charge.
So now LT picks up in a half-court trap this time. Morrison, having a little bit of trouble, finds Vaughn. Goodman now works it from the right corner, faces the double team, almost deflected by Lidke.
Lowry. Good movement on defense. They're coming to the ball. There you see Proviso throws it away. Good rotation on defense. The Lions are following right up where the ball is, moving with good enthusiasm, good quick feet. They look fresh out there. They look enthusiastic defensively.
So the trademark of the Panthers, that full court man-to-man pressure, has been averted so far by their coach Mark Schneider. He, of course, is in his first year replacing head coach Al Allen. Now Workington off the dribble will take it back outside to the perimeter. Runs into trouble, finds Davis off the right wing. It's a little bit beyond his range. He'll give it to Karinsky. Now Workington works off a Davis screen, has it at the free throw line. Pull-up jumper, wide open and in. So Workington jumps off to his first 2 points, and it's a 6-point lead now with 4 minutes left.
Lions not letting up here, just putting on the full court pressure. You got a 6-point lead. You want to just largen it. Get as big as a lead as you can early in this ballgame. You want to put the Panthers out of it right away if you're Ron Nikovich.
Morrison faces the double team. Now Lowry runs into trouble with Davis. And the lights are out here in the loudest arena and in Western Springs. The bedlam on Brainerd has turned into bedlam here as the power has gone out. And there you see the score. It's not 0-0. The Lions have jumped out to a good start and have a 6-point lead. So hopefully very soon the power will come back in. But until that happens, we'll keep you updated on how the season has gone thus far. Well, in fact, the season for the Lions, they have jumped out to a 4-1 start. Of course, in that Thanksgiving tournament where they picked up two victories, including a win over Westinghouse, who was ranked at the time number 4 in the state. Proviso West, meanwhile, has jumped out to a 5-0 start. This is their first conference game. Most recently, they beat Addison Trail by a final of 76-51. The 25-point victory was very typical of how they performed last year, and of course, they did lose 4 starters, so they rebounded nicely. And then they also beat Frem 2 weeks ago. The final was 66-49, a 17-point victory. Has really put this team on the map, and so they're out to a 5-0 start. Meanwhile, of course, Lyons Township, again in that Thanksgiving tournament, then they picked up victories over Hinsdale Central and Lincoln Way, leading to their number 14 ranking in the state.
Well, Mike, if you look at this basketball game here from both aspects here, the Lions offensively are out to a great start. Lidke has taken charge. He's hit his jumpers. Workington even came up, stepped up, hit a spot-up jumper. And the Lions have to continue to do that offensively, distribute the ball equally enough, and get some open shots because you could find them. But they're going to have to work hard for those baskets because we know the Panthers, with that foot quickness on defense, they're going to be very strong defensively. For the Panthers side now,
they had a
coming down low, they tried
Edison.
Pushing it down low. And they were very strong. They were not intimidated by the Lions' inside game, but the Lions' defense was definitely not intimidated. They came right in there. Davis got the block to start things off, and that interior defense by the Lions definitely thumbs up. They're looking sharp.
So the power is still out. I'm not sure if you heard public address announcer Doug Strucker just announced that the power will be back on in approximately 5 minutes. So the Lions maintain a 6-point advantage with just over four minutes left, as you see there on the scoreboard. It's a 6-point lead for LT. So far this season, the LT has jumped out to a good start, especially in the conference throughout all levels of basketball. The junior varsity team, though, lost
their
first
attempt. While we're in the dark,
it was to Hinsdale
Central.
They lost by 4 points. We'd like to
tell you that on Sunday, for just a few moments, we'd like to have you take a few moments of silence for our official scorekeeper, who has a birthday on Sunday, and he will turn the big 6-0. That's Mr. Tom Allen.
Another Allen, Al Allen, the former coach of Proviso West, recently retired, and of course Mark Schneider replaced him. So this is his first year as at the helm of the Panthers. Meanwhile, in his last season at the helm of the Lions is Coach Ron Nikovich. So this is a good matchup. It ends the rivalry between the two coaches. But as Coach Nikovich said, there really isn't a rivalry between the two, and a rivalry only comes when the schools have been going at it for a long time. Now, these schools have been going at it for a long time, and as usual, the crowd is a good turnout, and they'll have to sit through these next few minutes here without power as Lions hangs on to a 6-point lead. I was speaking of Lions so far in the conference season. They did pick up a win in the sophomore standings this evening, and they also picked up a win over Hinsdale Central by 3 points, 24-21 in a low-scoring battle, but still was a victory nonetheless. At the freshman level, they picked up a victory at the freshman B level and lost at the freshman A level. So the loss was to Hinsdale Central again at 48-27 was the final there. So overall, it's been a pretty good start for LT, and especially at the varsity level where they've jumped out to a 4-1 start.
You have to like what you're seeing throughout the season right now for the Lions at this varsity level, not only because of the stats, they don't really go so far, and the ranking is good to hear. But also, when you come out to see a game, it's exciting. It's every aspect about the game. You get your good inside-type players. You get your shot blocks from Steve Davis. Dennis Carroll going for a jam. He went for it on Lincoln Way. Even around the perimeter, you still have Steve Lidke to impress everybody.
Last year, the teams went at it, and Proviso West came out victorious both times, a 6-point victory early on at 59-53. Then they also picked up the victory at LT, and their most humiliating loss of the year was a 32-point defeat. The final score was 69-37. And there you see us over in the right-hand corner of your screen. And there's Sean Floss, my colleague here. The director of Lion Country Basketball here on Channel 29 is Dan Tomaszewski. Tonight's camera was provided by Josh McFadden, Nick Roche, and also Mike Strecker on the floor. The executive producer of Lion Country Basketball is John Wiesmith, and we're going to take a timeout here and come back as soon as the power comes back in, and so we'll hopefully we'll be with you shortly here on Channel 29.
By the time Sean was 5 years old, he already had 200 broken bones. Sean is one of 40,000 Americans who has osteogenesis imperfecta, a brittle bone disorder affecting all ages and races. For him, a simple handshake, a sneeze, or even a pat on the back may mean another cast.
My bones break real easy. With your help, I'm growing stronger.
Osteogenesis Imperfecta Foundation.
And the teams are set to resume action here after the short power failure and almost a backcourt violation. So now Morrison controls in the right wing. So we're glad you could join us here after the power failure. 4 minutes remain. It's a 7-1 LT lead. Inside shot up and an air ball, and Lidke corrals the rebound.
For Lidke, that's his third rebound tonight. And Mike, we talked about it earlier. This might play a role here in reducing the momentum factor with the lights out.
Well, it doesn't play a role early on. Mike Workentine has 4 points, and the LT lead is up to 8 now. 3.5 minutes left here. Now Lowry controls on the right wing. Top of the key is Morrison, guarded by Karinsky. Dribbles left against the screen now. Controls in the left wing is Vaughn. Inside, Lowry. Nice dish inside to Goodman. Was stolen away, and LT, then Workentine got caught traveling. So it's 9-1. LT's lead, 3 minutes, 13 seconds left here in the first quarter of play.
Both teams coming out, 4 turnovers for each so far. That's a 5th one for the Panthers.
Good hands by Karinsky leads to a Steve Lidke steal. Shot up and tip try by Davis, no good. Karinsky double pump, no good. Davis tries again. He is fouled inside by the Panthers. We'll have to wait and see who the foul is on.
But just look at the tenacity there. The Lions came out with good aggressiveness. You had Karinsky coming up with the tough shot. He had a man in his face. He couldn't hit it as he pulled up. Davis just came right in there, grabbed it out of the air like it's nobody's business, came right up strong.
Davis misses his first free throw attempt of the night. Davis has been one of the better free throw shooters on the team this year, rebounding from only a 61% performance last season. Davis now set to shoot his second. And he can't split the pair, so the rebound, good offensive rebound that time. Lidke gets caught shuffling his feet.
He had a hard time keeping his balance there, Mike, coming right on near the baseline, almost falling out of bounds, as you could see. Just couldn't regroup, getting the ball back in.
So now LT picks up the pressure here a little bit. Vaughn has no trouble breaking and tries to go coast to coast. Instead, kicks it outside to Morrison. Might have shuffled his feet. Gut hands that time by Karinsky. Has one man to beat. Tries to get up and score. So Chris Karinsky has his 3rd point of the evening, and it's now an 11-1 lead with 2.5 minutes remaining in the first quarter.
Well, Proviso so far just couldn't get into their game so far, even before the blackout. They didn't have a good tempo going, not good smooth offense.
They're going to credit the 3 to Mark Morrison. It looks like he might have had his foot on the line, but it's a 3-pointer, so the lead cut down to 7 now.
Good way for the Panthers to get back in it if they could connect from the outside shots, but the Lions doing a great job of finding the open men and getting the turnovers and going straight to the hoop.
Carroll had an open lane but couldn't quite convert. And so now you might have noticed that the Panthers picked up in that full court trap, and it looks like they're going to do it after every basket. But that, of course, was the first basket. Now Morrison outside, 3-pointer on the way. Tried to connect for the second straight time, and it'll go the other way.
John Steve Lidke, who was got caught there pushing down low.
So Lidke's second foul might force Coach Nikovich to go to the bench.
Now let's correct that. Now Lidke was not called with the foul. He was the one being pushed. They called the foul and turn on Proviso. Eric Goodman, the forward, to make a correction there. So we apologize for that, or at least I do anyway.
Now Carroll gives to Lidke off the right wing. Works off a Davis screen and takes it baseline from the corner now. Runs into trouble.
Good defense. Look at that right there, man to man. Good, strong defense. That's a defensive bonus right there. That's how the Panthers got that ball back right there, Mike.
Steve Davis got caught on an illegal screen, and so it's going to go the other way. We're under 2 minutes to play now. First quarter, the Lions lead at 7. The Panthers can cut it down to 5, but it's not going to happen here. Karinsky off the other way. Nice double pump and left-handed up and in. He has 5, and the lead is now back up to 9. There's another steal. Workentine has trouble. And so now the Panthers control. Vaughn, top of the key, kicks inside. Lowry Nice hands that time. I believe it was Dennis Carroll.
And it's off the knee of Lowry. It's going to be Lions ball. So far here, Mike, I want to make a point to stand out here. Neither team able to hold on to the ball right now. You have to credit, though, the Panther defense coming on quick. They're getting right in the Lions' face, making them work for their baskets, but the Lions coming right back equally.
Davis fakes the shot, now kicks outside Workington. An open three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound taken away by Vaughn. He pushes it up the floor for the Panthers. They're going to get a foul on LT. We're going to have to wait and see who the call is on. So under 1 minute now left. It's a nine-point advantage for LT. Karinsky's first of the game, fourth team on the Lions.
Paraiso just not able to jump out on offense and get into a good, smooth transitional game that they'd like.
Lowry and Davis now battle inside. Goodman sets up the offense. Now Vaughn. Goodman off the drive, off the glass and in.
And there you have it, Eric Goodman, that good smooth offensive game that he has as an asset. Just goes straight down the lane, kisses it off the glass.
So now here's that pressure, but not much of it from the Panthers. Good throw ahead pass that time from Workington. Karinsky fakes a three-pointer. And Lidke will set up the offense. Now tries to drive baseline and work off of Carroll's screen. Pull-up jumper by Lidke, no good. He's 2 for 3 from the field. Might have been pushed, but no call. Now Vaughn pushes it the other way for the Panthers. Nice turnaround dribble that time. Guarded by Carroll. Now top of the key. Shot outside. Up and in by Kelly at the buzzer. So the three-pointer by Kelly cuts the lead down to 4. And we'll be back for second quarter action right after this.
WLTL is 88.1 on your FM dial. WLTL brings you a variety of music like this, or like this. WLTL is also a great place for pro sports talk on your favorite teams, like the Cubs and Blackhawks. So if you like a variety of music and a variety of sports talk, tune in to WLTL 88.1 on your FM dial.
Back here, the teams resume action. Carroll controls top of the key. Now the give is to Workington, who set up the offense for the Lions. Davis has it way out on the perimeter. Now Karinsky, guarded by Kelly. And there'll be a foul on, I believe they're going to get Vaughn on this one. So Dwayne Vaughn, the brother of LaWayne, picks up his first foul. We are 14 seconds in here, and it's a four-point lead for the Lions after Kelly hit that three-pointer to send the teams to the bench and end the first quarter.
Dwayne Vaughn having a good game defensively. He's given Lidke fits all around here. Lidke having a tough time trying to get around him. He's just staying right in his face.
Kick outside to Karinsky. Three-pointer faked by Karinsky that time. Now Carroll controls on the corner. Davis with the jumper free throw line extended. No good. Got his own rebound. Puts it off the glass and in. So the off-balance jumper by Steve Davis leads to his second point. It's a six-point lead for LT.
And that's the size advantage that we talked about. If Davis could just sky for the ball and get those offensive boards, the second chance opportunities, translate them to baskets. Lions also good interior passing. Carroll and Davis helping out strong passing-wise.
Goodman, kick outside to Kelly, three-pointer, no good. Good rebound by Vaughn, he'll take it back outside, so the Panthers continue to work from the perimeter. Vaughn to Kelly, faces the double team. Kicks it outside in the corner, Goodman had trouble controlling, cross-court pass. Vaughn takes it baseline, faces the double team, good kickoff to Lowry inside, fingertip layup, no good. Good board that time, shot no good. Up and in, so attempt after attempt finally landed by Byron Henry, who just checked in his first 2 points, and now it's a four-point lead, the closest it's been in a while.
Henry falling back on that one, reaching with the left hand, nice composure up in the air.
Lidke kick out to Karinsky, now Workington. Faces the double team, runs into trouble. Vaughn tries to steal it, but good composure that time by Workington. Outside three-pointer on the way by Lidke and in.
Steve Lidke answers right back. There's trouble. Dwayne Vaughn up top puts on the defensive pressure on the junior Workington. Lidke right there finding his spot. He picks at the three and just nails it.
LT picks up in the half-court trap now. Vaughn takes it baseline. Works out of the corner. Kelly extends the offense for the Panthers. Now Goodman controls on the right wing. Kelly, good kick over to Vaughn. Three-pointer contested by Carroll nicely. So LT comes away with the air ball. And we're under 6 minutes now left. It's a seven-point lead for LT. Steve Lidke works off the right wing and looks to work off a Steve Davis screen. Nice pick and roll this time. Inside, kicked out, back outside. Lidke, having trouble, was touched by the Panthers. No backcourt violation, but this time the Panthers come away with it. Good throw ahead pass, knocked away by Karinsky to go out of bounds to the Lions.
Great turn of events there, Mike. Great defensive plays all around the court. Panthers came in with the pressure, relentless pressure. Lions couldn't get it back in. They had a tough time shooting it back in. And at the other end, Karinsky, good heads-up ball, bats the ball away. It bounces off a Panther player. Just great turn of events for both sides there defensively.
Defense is step slow this time as Carroll is open on the Davis pass. And so a nice job offensively by the Lions, and it's a nine-point lead.
And that's the interior passing I was talking about, Mike. Dennis Carroll, Steve Davis, good heads-up players. They got the nine-point advantage going out, 20-11, 5:15 left to go. Their things are very sharp right now on the Lions' side tonight.
Kelly faked the three-pointer, drive off the glass, no good. Good rebound that time by Vaughn, so he sticks it down, Dwayne Vaughn.
And he's working with both sides of the ball tonight, defensively putting the pressure on the guards, and offensively coming in, stepping in, getting his offensive rebounds. He's helping out big time. Carroll almost over and back call there. He had his foot right over the line and back over the half court line.
Lions having trouble, but there's the foul on Kelly, his first of the game, and the fifth on the team. Make it the sixth on the team, so they're not in the penalty yet. The Lions will have it out of bounds. Workentine set to inbound now. They'll play three from the perimeter. Workentine has it open on the wing. Now picks up his dribble and gives to Davis off the right wing. Free throw line extended. Guarded by Lowry. Has him outside on the perimeter. Workentine, nice spin dribble. Shot up. No good. Lions battle for the rebound, and they're going to call it out of bounds. It'll go to the Panthers.
Well, Workentine that time trying to grab the ball. As you can see, he had that left foot out past the baseline when he was grabbing the ball simultaneously. Therefore, that's the out of bounds call. Panthers down seven. The only way to get back in this ballgame is if Dwayne Vaughn could work offensively and find it down low to Lowry if they could work with the shot.
Lowry off the kickout now. Kelly, pass intended for Lowry. He's picked off by Karinsky. So 4 minutes remain. It's a 20-13, 7-point advantage for the Lions. Karinsky now guarded by Kelly. Gives it to Lidke. Works on the corner. And he's going to be fouled. So Vaughn doesn't like the call, but they're going to give it to him anyway. His second of the game.
But you got to like the good tenacity on defense by Vaughn, Mike, tonight. He's been very, very quick, good heads up, right in the face on Lidke. He is just relentless. He's giving Lidke the pressure, and then Lidke's, though, he's answering back, though. He's handling it well.
Steve Lidke, a 71% free throw shooter last year, hit 11 of 13 in the win against Westinghouse. Now he's set to shoot his first attempt of the night and tries to add to his 7-point total. He does in the bonus situation and has eight. So now the lead back up to eight for the Lions.
And he is a smooth free throw shooter. He hit some clutch free throws early in the season in the game against Westinghouse that helped the Lions go on route to a big victory here. And this is another team that you would love a victory against, Mike. Just bring back the great enthusiasm that we had against Westinghouse. Lions had some pretty mismatched type ball games. Lincoln Way, Hinsdale Central, not really big problems because of their talent that they have. But their talent is going to be evenly matched here tonight with the Panthers.
So the Lions full court press easily broken by the Panthers. Now Kelly, kickoff to Goodman in the right corner. Good defense by Davis that time. Knocked out of bounds off of Lidke, so the Panthers retain possession. Good job that time by Henry to knock it off of Steve Lidke.
Byron Henley and Lidke both up in the air at the same time right there, colliding out of bounds. Looked a little nasty at the time.
Goodman set to inbound and does to Kelly, who has a three-pointer. Might have been fouled, no call, and the rebound goes to Workentine.
This is what the Lions had to do, is capitalize on those missed opportunities from three-point land. Panthers trying to tee off from outside the three-point range. They're not looking sharp. They're not consistent from outside.
Lidke works off a Davis screen, tried to give it over on the other side of the lane to Carroll, but there was a foul, and it looks like they're going to get Lowry with his second. Now they're going to give it to LaWayne Vaughn. So Vaughn picks up his first, seventh on the team. So Lidke is set to shoot in the bonus situation here. Shot no good, so Lidke's 2 of 3 from the line. The lead up to 9 now. Vaughn, pull-up jumper on the way, no good.
Tough shot by Vaughn that time. He's trying to help take charge. LaWayne Vaughn, the brother of Dwayne, offensively, he's trying to push it down low. He's seeing he's not hitting it from the outside game. So when he's going up court, he's just taking it down low and he's taking charge, driving to the basket. It's going to be tough, though, because that Lion defense, when you have 6'8 Davis and 6'4 Carroll in your face, it's always going to be a tough pull-up jumper.
The Panthers are one of three from the line so far. Make it 2 of 4 as Vaughn connects on the second half of a two-shot foul. 3.5 minutes now remain. And it's a 22-14 lead for the Lions. Full court pressure this time by the Panthers, as you'll see after a made basket. Now Carroll gives to Davis, who works out of the corner. Top of the key is Workington. Another open three-pointer for him. So Mike Workington has 7, and the lead back up to 11 points now. 3 minutes left.
Lions have just found their shots, the right shots at the right time to help increase the lead. They've been going, working off smoothly on offense. And there's another turnover now against the Panthers on defense. The Lions are coming right back too, helping to capitalize off some miscued plays by the Panthers, who they're not looking too cohesively on offense.
Good pass that time from Carroll to Davis, who's going to have to kick it out. Kelly tries to catch up with it, but it'll go to the Lions. So Workington will inbound for LT and try to expand on the 11-point advantage. Now Korinsky to Workington, who works off the right wing. Works off a Davis screen this time. Now Korinsky, three-pointer. No good. Good board by Dennis Carroll. David, or Linky from
that.
The free throw line.
Carroll helps with the second chance opportunities, and it translates. Steve Litke hitting the jumper, nailing it. That's just the way the Lions have been doing it all night. Good work.
27-14 lead, 2 minutes, 25 seconds left. Litke already with 11 is on a 44-point pace, if you can believe that. I don't know if it'll maintain, but it equals a 13-point lead for the Lions, and there's a pass that'll go out of bounds to the Panthers.
And what do you know? A blocked shot coming from Steve Davis. Just another factor down low tonight for the Lions, the big force that Davis can be, and he's going to shine tonight, no doubt, against the Panthers. Now with that 13-point advantage, the Panthers, the only way to come back, well, they didn't do it there. I was going to say some smooth passing was not sharp. Oh, look out.
So the turnover gives it to the Panthers. Now Vaughn off the turnaround dribble. And they're going to get a foul this time. It looks like they're going to get Dennis Carroll with the whistle, his first of the game.
If you're Ron Nikovic, you can't be happy with what you're seeing. Just not good, clean basketball on both sides of the floor so far in that turn of events. He's a, I wouldn't say a perfectionist, but he's definitely can't be happy with what he just saw there.
Now Goodman at the line hasn't shot a free throw yet tonight. Tries to cut the lead to 12, free throw in. So the 12-point advantage for the Lions, nearly their largest. And you have to be happy if you're an LT fan with only 2 minutes left here in the half.
And if the Panthers are going to come back here, Goodman is going to be one of those men who has to step up offensively. He's got a great game behind him, good score. He can lead if he has to.
As you heard, both teams in the bonus, so they'll shoot 1-1 from here on out in the half. 2 minutes are left. Litke now works off the left wing, drives baseline. He'll take it back out, looks for a shot. And they're going to call a foul. If he hadn't passed off, he might have been at the free throw line, but they're going to be anyway because the Panthers are in the penalty.
Well, that time, LaWayne Vaughn was putting the pressure defensively on Litke. And if Litke doesn't deal with Dwayne Vaughn, he has to deal with LaWayne Vaughn. Both of these two brothers have been just equally as important on the defensive side tonight to try to take out Litke's game, and they haven't done it so far. Litke has had great composure. He's held off of it. He's found his spots around the floor, and he's hit his threes. But offensively, though, LaWayne Vaughn or Dwayne Vaughn, when they've come to the court, they've lost the ball on occasions. They've spot up, hit a few threes, but more than that, they've had some trouble bringing it up court. The Lions have been able to put the pressure on and able to steal the ball easily at times.
Litke is 4 of 5 from the line. It's a 14-point lead now, under 2 minutes to play in the half. LT pressure this time, and Morrison tries to control and does to Kelly. Works off the left timeline. Vaughn inside, kicks it back outside. Kelly fakes a three-pointer. Vaughn works it off the left wing. Now faces the double team, gives it to Morrison off the right wing. Shot inside by Henry, no good, too long. Davis, outlet pass too quickly, and the Lions finally come away with it.
Good thing Workington was back there, helped prevent any trouble from happening there with the Panthers trying to get back into this ballgame. They're going to be very aggressive coming at them on both sides of the floor. Nice move by Littke going baseline. Nice little finger roll layup. Working smooth, and as I said, that's an example there. He has not let the defense of the Vaughn brothers ruin his game tonight.
Morrison has it top of the key. Faces the double team now. Vaughn. Shot up by Lowry, no good. Good board that time by Dennis Carroll. He had nice position. Now under 1 minute remain, 40 seconds to be exact. It's the 31-15, 16-point advantage now for the Lions. Littke works off a Davis screen. We'll set it up for LT. Not much movement off the ball here besides Mike Warkenstein. So LT looking for their last shot. It's 25 seconds left. Littke has trouble. Now he's going to drive inside. Kick outside to Davis. Baseline jumper on the way. No good. Good rebound by Littke, who kicks it outside to Warkenstein. Three-pointer rimming good. So Warkenstein has really come out shooting. He has 10 and lead. 7 seconds left. 3 seconds to shoot. Kelly looks for the shot. Morrison from the corner at the buzzer. No good. So that'll put us to halftime. It's a 19-point lead for LT. As you see, it's a 34-15 lead for the Lions. We'll be back with halftime analysis right after this.
Mr. Bob Dovalina, Mr. Dovalina, 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 Mr. Bob Dovalina.
That was cool.
Yeah. Thank you, Varsity Pom Pom Squad.
Lions Township, a great place to go to school. A place to learn and have fun too. a place to get involved and participate with great clubs and activities. LT is a place with school spirit. For more information, or to decide if LT is the place for you, contact South Campus Main Office.
So the teams are just about set to start the second half here. LT clings to a 19-point lead, and Sean, would you have expected this coming in?
No, not at all. I think the reason for it, though, you have to say, is the Panthers' offense has been erratic. Their transitional game has not been too smooth. The Lions have come with the pressure on defense all night long, and they've given the Panthers problems. They've not been able to handle it so far. For the Lions coming back, though, the way to stay involved, though, in this ball game, to maintain the lead, you have to get the ball to Litke, get the ball to Workentine. They've had the hot shots so far tonight. They've been shooting good. And also down low, Carroll and Davis, can't say enough about them. They've stayed active. They've stayed involved on the inside part of the ball game. They've gotten the second chance opportunities to help keep the Lions' scoring chances rising. And the Panthers, the only way to get back into this game is, as I said, smoothing out the offense. They have to work maybe a little half-court game and try to calm down things, put off the pressure that the Lions have been coming at them with, and try to find some open spots on the floor and hit those jumpers, because they can't hit them when they want to.
An interesting note, Coach Nikovich hasn't made a substitution yet, but it's worked thus far. Again, LT maintains a 19-point lead. And so now Goodman will inbound for the Panthers and get things underway. They're going to have to come out fast and probably pick up in a press if they're going to cut into this lead. Now Lowry on the floor along with Vaughn, who has the ball. Alley-oop pass intercepted by Workentine, so it'll go the other way. We've played 15 seconds and we're scoreless here in the second half.
The Proviso would have connected on that alley-oop. That would have been a great start. Good momentum factor to lead off the half.
Davis works down low but shuffled his feet. It'll go the other way. So turnovers at each end of the floor has brought us to a stall here. It's a 19-point lead for LT.
And once again, both teams coming out offensively not too smooth in action.
Lowry gives to Vaughn, who works top of the key. Now Morrison takes it and gives it to Vaughn, who drives baseline. Shot off the glass, no good. Too strong that time. Good follow by Connor, who was fouled.
Ramil Connor, the senior, he's got good size, 6'4", 225. He'll be able to match up down low with Carroll. He matches him height for height, and he'll be a good force for him down low.
Connor misses the left on the free throw.
This is the way, though, for the Panthers to get back in it. If they could get the ball involved down low to Connor, or maybe get it to Lowry, because they have to match up and try to put off that interior advantage that the Lions have down low.
So Connor connects on the second half of the pair. So now LT ready to set up the offense. So again, the Panthers don't come up in much of a press. Karinsky has it top of the key. LT working on the perimeter. Litke again for three, and that one's in. So it works for him in the first half, and it's working for him in the second half.
Litke picking up right where he left off in the first half. As you said, that outside shooting, they have to keep the ball in his hands, as I mentioned. Keep him involved. He's got the hot shot tonight. That's a way for the Lions to keep the large lead.
Shot knocked out of bounds. Interesting note, Lions has four of the top six scorers in the conference. It was because of that 70-point outburst that they put together against Hinsdale Central. Now Morrison from the outside, three-pointer in. So he answers Litke at the other end. His second three-pointer of the game cuts the lead down to 19.
And the Panthers have been able to connect on some threes on occasions, but just not consistently enough. They have to work the ball down low if they want to come back in this game. Some equal distribution from the outside and inside.
Litke, nice drive, baseline. So he scores once more.
And Litke's definitely been the man so far offensively. He's taken charge. He's led the Lions into this big crusade, taking a large lead.
Lowry answers at the other end. So they refine their offense here a little bit. And it played LT to a standstill here in the second half.
Proviso West coming pretty smooth. They got a good game plan working to try to get back into it.
Carroll, nice kick out to Litke, who gives to Davis. Jumper on the way, too short. And we have a whistle. It'll go the other way, so it looks like it's going to be a foul on LT.
Coach Nikovich just telling the boys, keep your head in the game, stay focused, don't let anything get out of hand. You got a nice, comfortable lead, but you want to largen it as much as you can.
So now all of a sudden, Davis has three fouls, whereas LT really hadn't had any foul trouble previous to that time. Shot inside, no good. Carroll corrals the rebound. So they'll come the other way. Korinsky pushes the ball up for LT, now controls on the right wing. Looks to pass to Lidke, and now does on the right wing. Works off a Davis screen. He'll take it baseline. Shot or pass knocked out of bounds, and LT will retain possession.
Lidke just doing his best working down on the floor there, fighting down baseline there. He's got two men in his face, just trying to get that outlet pass going.
Workentine's inbound was to Lidke, who was too strong on the free throw. 5.5 minutes left. It's a 39-21 advantage for LT. Vaughn runs into trouble, but he'll set up amid the double team. Long pass knocked to Morrison. Three-pointer on the way. So Morrison has come out shooting here in the second half. His third three-point field goal. He has 9 overall, and now with only 5 minutes left, it's a 14-point lead.
Mark Morrison has been the big factor to help the Panthers try to jump back into this ballgame. He's been the main man they've been relying on from the outside.
Davis controls from the corner. Give to Workentine. Now Korinsky works off a Davis screen on the right wing. Top of the key is Lidke. Pass to the corner. Steve Davis. Shot on the way. No good.
That's Dennis Carroll with the over-the-back call. He was a little out of position there, fighting for the rebound. Now Ron Nikovich wants a timeout. He wants to regroup here. You have a 15-point lead. It's a pretty big advantage against a team like this, Mike, but Proviso is starting to get back into the game plan here. They're finding their open shots, and Mark Morrison has been a big spark plug off the bench for them, helping them get back into this ballgame. And the Lions losing a little bit of the focus. That's why Nikovich called that timeout. They want to regain that focus and come out with some good team chemistry once again.
So as we said, the Panthers lost four starters. They were Anthony Knox, who had 11 points per game and was among the leaders in rebounding and shot blocking. They also lost Roy Shannon, who I believe is playing college ball, averaged 10 points per game last year. Deion Lewis and Brian Wardell, the backcourt that played really consistently for the Panthers, is gone. But as you've seen, the Panthers do have a pretty good arsenal. They just haven't been shooting well from the perimeter. So I really think that Proviso West is too good a team not to make a run, but it looks like LT has the men to, you know, answer that run, and we'll see how things unravel here. With 4 minutes and 45 seconds left in the third quarter of play, LT hangs on to that 15-point lead.
For the Panthers so far, getting back into the ball game, it's been a good offensive sound game for them. They've come right back. They have not lost the ball on turnovers. They've held off the pressure from the Lions. They have good passing around the perimeter there. Good ball distribution.
Goodman, cross-court pass to Vaughn. Guarded by Lidke, looks to get rid of it now, and he'll take it top of the key. Pass inside, intended for Lowry, knocked outside to Morrison. Another three-pointer on the way, no good. Nice tip in by Vaughn.
LaWayne Vaughn just skying right through the lane there, coming the offensive rebound, just taking his game to another level.
Carroll runs into the double team. Nice kickoff to Workentine, drives inside. Knocked away, it'll go out of bounds, and LT will have possession. 4 minutes left now. 13-point lead for LT. So the first substitution here, Steve Davis will sit down with those three fouls. Mark Wojtovich, he'll well number 54, checks in for LT.
Slowly but surely, Panthers clawing back at that deficit, taking bits and pieces off of it. They're fighting back.
Lidke from the free throw line extended, scored, and a foul is on Morrison.
And now a three-point opportunity for Lidke. That would just be another big blow to the Panthers' defense. That's Steve Lidke for you. All night long, he's not let up. He's come back. He's taken charge offensively and defensively. He's come up with a heads-up tenacity coming up on the perimeter there. But right now, three-point opportunity, great free throw shooter, smooth offensive player.
Lidke has 22 points, and the referee is going to take Vaughn over to the scorer's table. I'm not sure what the conflict is about.
It just looks to be that Vaughn might be bleeding a little bit. He might have to wipe it off. But they have the rules now that they have, not only in the college level but the high school level, that you have to leave the game immediately, and in the professional level also. Once you have any blood or any spurts of blood along on the jersey, found on the jersey, and you have to leave.
So Lidke now connects on the three-point play. He has 23 points. Kelly runs into trouble. And pass intended for Morrison, knocked away, and it's going to go to LT. So the pressure defense really helping LT out to this big advantage. We're under 4 minutes left in the third quarter.
And that's the thing that Coach Nikovich talked about with these young men. You have to come right back with what got you there. It's that defense, good heads-up defense. They've made the Panthers play erratic on offense, and they're coming right back with it again.
Workentine, top of the key to Kerensky. Now Steve Lidke works off a Wojtovich screen. Has it free throw line extended. Wojtovich to Lidke. Drives baseline on. Well, they're going to call a charge. Or was that out of bounds? I couldn't quite get that one.
It was out of bounds, Mike, here from this angle as I could see. Lidke, he was pushing in a little bit. He dribbled the ball right there in the baseline. He's running out of room. But good defense. They did not give up the baseline there, the Panthers.
Morrison. Kelly now. The give is to Vaughn. Sets up in the triple threat on Workentine. Morrison controls off the right wing. Drives baseline. Left open. Left hand layup no good. And LT comes away with it. So the missed conversion that time by Morrison leads to the LT possession. 3 minutes now left in the third quarter.
Lions just have another opportunity here to largen that lead. Steve Lidke has been the man so far. He's going to take it again.
Wojtovich left open at the free throw lines, and he hits. So Mark Wojtovich has his first 2 points in the game and has played really consistently for LT coming off the bench.
And if they can get it, that's what they need. A jumper off the bench, a few points off the bench at least to help with some good team contributions.
Lowry was fouled. It looks like they're going to get Wojtovich on this foul. No, it's Workentine's third, so both Davis and Workentine have three now.
But for the Lions, though, overall, Mike, that's 14 fouls so far here with 2:40 left in the third quarter to go. A little bit of some foul trouble there, not major, though.
Vaughn looks to inbound and does. On the left wing now, Vaughn controls. Kelly to Vaughn. This is Dwayne, drives baseline. And they're going to have a foul down low. I think they're going to get Workentine on this one. And that would be his fourth, so here comes the substitution. So Graham Alexa comes in and checks in for Workentine, who just picked up that fourth foul. Alexa makes his first appearance of the game. And he knocks the ball away on the inbound pass.
Wow, the team fouls have just been creeping up higher and higher here, and we are early in this second half here. There's still plenty of time left to go, a whole fourth quarter to go, and it's not looking good for the Lions with foul trouble so far.
So Wojtovich with his first foul. 44-26 the score. Luane Vaughn inbounds to his brother Dwayne. Now Vaughn for three. Missed it left. Wojtovich comes away with her board.
Things got out of hand a little bit so far on that drive there by the Lions defensively. They want to come back here. What they have to look for is the good ball movement.
Kerensky finds Wojtovich, who sinks his second, so he's 2 for 2 from the floor.
And that's a good ball movement right there. Kerensky finds the open man, boom, gets it to Wojtovich. He hits the jumper, and he's been helping off the bench, as we mentioned, with those spot-up jumpers.
Lowry.
And there's the foul. Telly Lowry. Good defense by Graham Alexa. He's made two solid defensive plays as he came off the bench tonight. That's what the Lions look for in order to maintain a large lead that they have.
Lowry second now. We're under 2 minutes to play. It's a 20-point lead for LT, so they have outscored the Panthers by one in this quarter. Now the Panthers pick up in the press. LT ready to break it, and they do, and Steve Lidke now sets a drive on Kelly. Graham Alexa runs into the double team but breaks it. Kerensky, three-pointer from the right wing, no good. Offensive rebound, Dennis Carroll.
Lions showing on offense that they don't have to rely on Lidke as much now. They've got some help from Wojtovich with those jumpers, but they're moving the ball around nicely.
Wojtovich has the ball knocked away. Vaughn off the break, has Alexa to beat, and Graham's going to pick up the foul. So his first.
And that now marks the seventh team foul, I believe, there on the Lions, and it's just a free throw game right now the rest of the way for the Panthers. All they have to do is connect on those free throws, and that could be a big turnaround in this ball game. If they could hit at least 80% of their free throws so far the rest of the way, they could take a big chunk out of that deficit.
Vaughn hits the front end of a 1-1, so he'll get the bonus. That was his first free throw attempt of the game. 1.5 minutes left. It's a 19-point lead for LT.
Vaughn has had an excellent game in the first half defensively. Right in the face of Lidke, But Lidke, with those points, just did not let it bother him, and he continues to shine in the second half.
Nice job by Graham Alexa to come away with the deflected pass. Runs into trouble again. Tries to find Karinsky and does, but Karinsky can't save it. It's going to go to the Panthers.
Wow. Big turnaround here. Panthers defense has paved the way in order for them to come back in here. And as you see their head coach, he's aggressive, and it just pours out onto the court from the team with that leadership. That good aggressive defense has just helped them come back into this game.
So a lot of contact that time. No whistle, though. Now Vaughn controls off the right wing, runs into trouble, and goes out of bounds. So didn't look like there was a deflection, but LT's going to have the ball. 46-28 with a minute 11 left in the third.
And Mike, that's another example there why the Panthers are not leading in this ball game, or not even close to leading, because on offense they still have their troubles, and Vaughn has not been able to handle the ball well up along the perimeter. And that time there wasn't great pressure on him, but he still lost the ball. So if the Panthers want to get back in it, they have to prevent those turnovers.
So again, the pressure by the Panthers, and this time it's knocked out of bounds. So LT will have it at the timeline here. 1 minute, 8 seconds left now. So Alexa set to inbound, and the Panther press is picking up.
Now they have to clarify the positioning there at the court. Chris Karinsky fighting for his ground against Dwan Kelly. Kelly talking things up with Karinsky half court, so Proviso's coming back in strong. And you might say Karinsky might have got the nod there in that little confrontation. Kelly with a foul being called on him. Graham Alexa getting ready to inbound the ball, has had a fine game so far coming off the bench. He's helped offensively. Lions had to prevent those turnovers, though. That's been creeping up on them. Defensively, the Panthers have been in their face so far the past couple of minutes.
Wojtovic faces the double team. Gives it to Karinsky, but his foot was out of bounds, so the Panthers now, the pressure picking up and the turnovers are starting to add up for the Lions.
One of the few advantages of being a big man in basketball, you lose the awareness of where your feet are at times. You got those long legs and your feet might be creeping up out of bounds, and you got the ball 5 inches here inside the court. That's trouble sometimes.
Dwayne Vaughn directs the offense. Kelly top of the key now. Lowry outside on the perimeter. Vaughn guarded by Carroll. Tries to work off the dribble. Pass deflected by Wojtovic. The outlet pass knocked out of bounds. And it's going to go to the Panthers.
Right there, the Lions with the heads-up defense. Panthers trying to get a little fancy with the ball. The Lions batting the ball away. And the Lions coming defensively, trying to put the stop on them to try to prevent those fancy moves.
30 seconds left. Vaughn inside, drive, scored, and a foul should be on Wojtovic.
And if he can hit this free throw, it'll just be a big play right here. You're winding down in the third quarter for the Panthers. They move the ball around nice and slow, taking their time. They're patient on offense, showing that they have confidence that they can come back in this ballgame in the final 8 minutes of basketball.
23 seconds left. Vaughn has made his only two free throws of the game. Now tries to connect on the three-point play. Knocks it down. So it's a 15-point lead now for LT. Amid Panther pressure, Chris Karinsky sets to bring it up for the Lions. Throw ahead pass to Alexa at the timeline. Now Karinsky drives inside. Shot off, no good. 13 seconds left. Carroll takes it outside for LT. 10 seconds. Lidke controls. Down to five now. Looking for a shot. Picked off by Kelly. 1 second left. Shot at the buzzer. No. Rimming, no. So it was too long. 15 point lead for LT, and we're going to take a timeout here, and we'll be back with fourth quarter action right after this.
Here's just a little sample of what types of music WLTL plays. Everything from rap, classic rock, and even hard rock. If you like this variety of music, then tune in to WLTL weekdays from 3 o'clock to 10 o'clock p.m.
Hello and welcome back to the North Campus Fieldhouse here at Lyons Township High School. Along with my colleague Sean Floss, I'm Mike Jarosek, and we're glad to be bringing you this coverage of Lyon Country Basketball here on Channel 29. Sean, the lead is 15 points for LT, but it has changed off and on here in the third quarter. What do you think?
Oh, it could change quickly. Proviso West could change this game around here because of the defense that they've come up with. Good tenacity, and offensively they've been able to score.
Perinsky ran into trouble, and the Panthers come away with it. Vaughn, throw ahead pass. So that's the third time the Panthers have tried that, and it hasn't worked yet. So now we've played 20 seconds here into the fourth quarter, and there's no indication that the Panthers are ready to come back.
Panthers have that good athleticism, as we've seen. They've been able to display it, but they're not working it, though, as a team equally. They're trying to go with those alley-oops there, and they're getting a little too fancy, and that's not the way you come back in the ballgame. You do that when you're up by 15, work with a little alley-oop. If you want to come back here, you got to look with good ball distribution. You got to come back and find the open man.
Ball knocked out of bounds by Vaughn, so LT has the ball. Now here comes Mike Workentine. He's going to check in for Chris Kerensky. Workentine, of course, with those four fouls, so it'll be interesting to see how long he can stay in here. Alexa inbounds to Workentine. Works amid Panther pressure. Carroll now works off the left wing. Workentine to Alexa, top of the key. Works off the dribble against Vaughn. Has a pass deflected, and nice save that time to his brother Dwayne. Shot up and in by Dwayne Vaughn, so he goes coast to coast, and that's the kind of play that the Panthers are well known for.
Yeah, they're not a good team half-court offense, but for the transitional game, they've been able to translate those points off turnovers.
So the foul on Dwayne Vaughn will be his third of the game. I have him with three anyway. 6 minutes, 48 seconds left. It's a 46-33, 13-point advantage for LT.
Now they take a timeout, and Mike, I have to say, in my opinion, this has been one of the toughest defenses the Lions have played all season long, aside from maybe that St. Joe's game on the Saturday night in the Thanksgiving tournament, and we saw what happened there, how they had the trouble scoring. But the only way I think the Lions, offensively, they come through is because Steve Litke has been hot. He's been able to hit his jumpers. And also, they haven't had as much trouble, though, handling Proviso West when they've come back on offense. Proviso's just been carelessly turning the ball over. They've had trouble. They had a chance to get back into it numerous times and just throwing the ball away and losing it on alley-oops or so forth. But the Lions, though, have had a difficult time in the past few minutes, ending the third quarter, coming into the fourth quarter with that defense. It's just been swarming all around. Dwayne Vaughn and Dwayne Vaughn did great early against Litke, but now when you look at the whole team pattern on defense, that full-court press has just been, it's been terrific for Proviso West.
So the team's just about set to resume fourth quarter action here. 6 minutes, 48 seconds remain, so we played a minute and 12 seconds here into the fourth quarter, and LT has a 13-point lead. Workentine inbounds to Carroll. Throw ahead pass. Dennis Carroll now controls near the timeline. Kerensky faced the double team. There's the foul outside on Goodman. So Goodman's second foul of the game. Won't quite put LT on the free throw line. That's only their fifth team foul of the second half.
That could be important later in this ballgame if Proviso West gets in that foul trouble. You want to see men like Litke going to the free throw line for the Lions. Big clutch player.
Litke crosses the timeline. Now Kerensky has it on the left wing. Face the double team, now Kelly. Kerensky drives baseline, but they're going to call a charge. So Kerensky's second foul comes with 6.5 minutes left here.
I have to go with the referees at this point. That was a good call. I got a good clean shot of it there. As you can see, the man had the position there, and Kerensky just fell right into him there.
Kelly on the throw-ahead pass to Dwayne Vaughn. Face the double team. Kerensky comes out to guard him. Now Kelly controls top of the key. He'll pull up for a three-pointer. You haven't seen that very often, but Kelly knocks it down and likes it. His second three-pointer of the game. He has six in the game.
Big-time play for the Panthers. They just have to keep their composure and stay away from the fouls when they come back on defense.
Davis, who is checked back in for LT. Kerensky now works off of Davis' screen. Has a free throw line extended. Looks to get rid of it and does to Davis. Now Kerensky renews his dribble. Gives it to Litke. Runs into trouble. Hasn't scored in a while, Steve Litke has. And the foul will be on, it looks like they're going to get Lowry on this one. So Lowry's third.
That's going to mark the 16th foul now for the Panthers. So things are getting even closer to the bonus situation. And I think that's where the Lions might have the big advantage there.
Workentine set to inbound and finally finds Lidke. Double pump wow. jumper. Steve Lidke has been the scoring machine for the Lions so far tonight. 5 minutes, 45 seconds left.
Money in the bank, Michael. Money in the bank. Lidke, when they've gone to him, he has not disappointed anyone. He has came. People come here to watch the Lions play, and also they want to see a good show from a man like Lidke. He's stepped up last year as a junior, and now as a senior hasn't been different. He's shown up for the big games all year round, and this is just another mark for him.
Lidke now 26 points. The biggest outburst that a Lion has had in a long, long time, as long as I can remember.
11-point advantage now, 49-36. Lions ball here.
This one falling out of the hands of the Panthers in a hurry now. Workentine will inbound and wasting no time to Lidke. Workentine fake the three. Karinsky picking up the offensive pace now for the Lions. He'll take it baseline and is fouled. They're going to get either Lowry or Kelly on this one.
That marks the bonus now, so see if Karinsky has enough energy left in him to concentrate at the free throw line, because this could be tough. This could be a factor to look at. You might have some tired players out there for the Lions. They don't get much rest. Of course, Davis and Workentine were in the foul trouble, but men like Carroll and Karinsky and Lidke were pretty much out there the whole ball game tonight. And Nikovich works with the starters. There's no doubt about it. He works with the big horses. What he's got there, he'll work with them throughout that whole entire ball game, and that's why they have that 50-36 lead now.
Karinsky has 6 points. He's 2 of 3 from the line so far. 5.5 minutes left, and he knocks it down. So he's 3 of 4 in the game. It's a 51-36 lead for the Lions. Karinsky, battling on the inbound pass, will pick up the foul. The fans don't like it, but it did look like it was a foul. It'll be his third of the game.
When LT comes back offensively, what they have to look for here, they cannot panic offensively. They want to be choosy and get nice, good shot selection, because Proviso West is coming after them. They're the ones who have to get back in it. Just let them come after you and foul you. The Lions can hit those free throws. They're confident in it. They just have to be nice and patient on offense, prevent the turnovers, because the clock is on their side now. They got the Panthers chasing them. They just have to work patiently on offense right now.
Vaughn misses his fourth attempt from the line. He hit his previous three. Now LT breaks the pressure. Workentine, base of the double team, kicks it off to Karinsky. Top of the key. Now Davis, nice give. Down baseline, cross-court pass intended for Carroll, knocked away, and the Panthers run away with it. So now they come up on the right wing. Vaughn takes it outside to Morrison. Good pass inside. Lowry fights for it, but couldn't convert. Goodman, turnaround jumper
wow.
blocked by Davis.
Tough interior defense.
Vaughn comes away with the score. That was Luane Vaughn, has 5 points. 51-38 the score.
Good solid defense. Right now, Lions, as I said, work the ball around evenly. Just be patient.
Workentine fakes the three. Kicks it left wing to Karinsky. He'll slow things down now. Under 5 minutes to play. Karinsky, three-pointer on the way and in.
Big-time basket. Just what you needed for the Lions side here. When they've had the shot selections out there, they've picked their shots that they wanted. Karinsky picks it. He knows he can hit it, and he goes there and knocks it down.
Good screen that time by Steve Davis to open up Chris Karinsky for that opportunity. Chris Karinsky now has 10 points in the game. Vaughn finds himself open, tries to force the shot. No good. It'll be a foul. I believe they're going to get Steve Lidke on this one. So Lidke picks up his only second foul of the game. But they are in the penalty, and Vaughn will go to the line.
That's surprising. Lidke's been so active, yet only 2 fouls here in the game. He's not gotten into the foul trouble like everybody else. Just shows you how he's been able to hold off, put the defensive pressure on, but yet not get in the foul trouble, prevent the foul number from creeping up.
Vaughn hits the front end of the 1-1. He'll shoot for the second free throw and try to cut into the lead now. It's 54-39, LT advantage. Vaughn, 5 of 6 from the line now. And they'll pick up the pressure here. So Karinsky looks to inbound and does to Workentine. Faces the double team. And the foul should be on Morrison. So LT doing a good job, and Workentine's going to go to the line. 14-point lead for LT.
For Morrison, he's been quiet for a while in this ball game. He's been a deep threat from the three-point land, but so far right here, he's been offensively, he's been quiet.
Workentine hasn't shot a free throw yet tonight. At the sophomore level last year, he was a 76% free throw shooter. He was the best on the team, but he comes up empty on this trip. So now Vaughn brings it front court. Double pump pass, and they're going to bring it out and try to shoot the threes. Vaughn, Dwayne Vaughn this time, no good. Good rebound by Kerensky.
Good job of boxing out that time. You got to rely on your guards when that long shot goes up. It's going to be a long rebound. You need the guards to box out.
Lidke runs into trouble. It'll go out of bounds to the Lions. Under 4 minutes now left.
This is crunch time. It's going to be very tight here. It's going to be a man-on-man type of ball game. Whoever's got the best skills right here, he's going to shine right now.
Pass knocked out of bounds. It looked like it was off Vaughn, but they're going to call it off of Lidke. And it's going to be freight train that time by the second official. So a good call, I really think so. The first official didn't have a good angle. So working team will inbound for the Lions. The proviso coach is out of the coaching box, so you might want to watch out for that.
Yeah, the referee going to talk to him, the situation, explain to him what just happened there in that sudden turn of events there.
The proviso coach doesn't like this at all. I don't know if we can get a camera angle on that, but there's a major confrontation here.
Good thing he calmed down, because that could have been a technical foul, Mike, and if things get out of hand, that could just ruin this ballgame for Proviso West. It could fall apart if something like that happens.
Kerensky takes it left wing, and now Workington. Lidke tries to work off a Davis screen, takes it baseline. He's had this shot all night, and he'll hit it once more. So Lidke has been all over. He's got 27.
Nice soft touch, baseline jumper, tough shot, a little pull-up jumper. Gets a nice soft roll on the basket there, looking smart.
Dwayne Vaughn misses, and Carroll comes away with it. So now LT having trouble getting it past the timeline, but Workington now has it. Davis to Workington. Lidke controls. He'll take it baseline once more from the corner. Works off a Davis screen. Vaughn does a good job on defense. Workington comes away with the loose ball. Knocked away. It'll go to LT. 3 minutes now left. It's a 16-point lead for LT.
If you're Proviso West, you want to come back into this ball game on offense. You don't want to be too desperate looking for the threes, but time is running out. But offensively, you have to look for your shots. Be very quick with it.
Lidke inside to Davis. Could have gone straight up with it, but didn't. And there'll be a foul. Are they going to get Lowry on this one? If indeed it is, it would be his fifth foul of the game.
Davis that time muscling up strong. It's his free throws to hit right now, and just larging that lead. If you're the Lions, they got a good momentum going here, good roll that they're on. It's looking pretty positive so far, under 3 minutes left.
So Lowry checks out after picking up his fifth foul with 2:56 left. He finishes with 3 points, but more importantly, five fouls. So he was pretty ineffective. Steve Davis did a really good job defending him. But Davis 0 for 3 from the line, which has been a change for him so far.
Well, his shot blocking is what the Lions counted on tonight, what they needed, and he came through big time. They needed him to display that size advantage that he had down low, and he came through.
Davis 0 for 4 now, and Dwayne Vaughn controls on the left wing. He's going to have to speed things up here. Under 3 minutes left, it's a 16-point lead. Morrison, three-pointer. Nothing but the bottom of the net. So Morrison looks like a pretty good shooter. He has 12 for all on three-pointers.
My, oh, my, that kid. He's got a nice stroke. Just smooth shooter from outside.
Kerensky pass to no one in particular will go out of bounds to the Panthers.
That's been a rarity on occasions throughout the season. You don't see the Lions throwing the ball away much. That just gives credit back to the defense of the Panthers.
Dwayne Vaughn finds his brother, Luane, top of the key, inside. Morrison on the corner gives it to Luane. They're going to have to look for a shot here pretty quickly, and Kerensky's going to pick up the foul. So Chris's foul, I've got him with four.
There you see the time left, 2:21, just getting closer and closer now. Just a free throw game here. If the Panthers want to come back, they have to connect with those free throws. It's very important.
It's still only a 13-point game. Vaughn, no good on the free throw attempt, but good job by Henry to chase it down. Vaughn now faces the double team, kicks it outside. Good pass. Luane Vaughn for three, no good. And Davis corrals the rebound. 2 minutes left now. 13-point lead for LT. Kerensky faces Panther pressure. Kick ahead, Workington from the free throw line. Jumper on the way, no good. Missed it left. Rebound taken away by Vaughn. Looks to throw it ahead. Instead, he'll take it himself. Spinning, jumper on the way, no good. Davis another rebound, but knocked away to Luane Vaughn. We're going to have a foul down low. It should be on Davis. I have him with four fouls.
Well, the Lions got a little lucky there that the Panthers did not capitalize on the missed jumper by the Lions offensively, but so far this is what the Panthers have to do if they want to fight back into this. They have to hit those free throws. They have to take advantage of the turnovers that the Lions are going to make late in this ball game. They have to do it quickly.
Vaughn missed the free throw. The foul tried, and there'll be another whistle. So we're going to go the other way with it. Vaughn has been a disappointing 1-for-4 from the line. And the foul's on Goodman. So with only a minute and 43 seconds left, it's still a 13-point lead, and that might be it for the Panthers tonight.
It's been a wild night all night long. You know, Ninkovich's last year, anything can happen, as they say, and the lights went out, so anything could happen, and it did. But it did not change the complexion of the game, because as it started out, the Lions had the comfortable lead. They came out sound on offense, and defensively, they just wreaked havoc over the Panthers' offense, and they picked up right where they left off once the lights came back on, and throughout the course of the ball game, they've done that defensively, putting the heat on them.
So Goodman's fourth foul of the game, and Proviso West still in the penalty, so Carroll set to shoot his first free throws of the game. And Sean, Lions came into this game as the 14th ranked team in the state. If they can indeed hang on and win this game, what do you think it'll do to their ranking?
Well, it's definitely going to go up, but it'll be interesting to see with the other teams how they fared in their ball games. But I'm pretty sure it'll go up at least five notches, because this is a big victory. Proviso West is a quality team. They came in here and they put trouble on this team, just like they did with Westinghouse. It was just the same type of situation, but still you had that one loss that lingers with St. Joe's, because St. Joe's is right around our spot there in the rankings, and they're going to be battling with us for that top spot there. But still, it's a terrific record, and when they've taken teams that had the disadvantage against us, they've beating them convincingly. You don't want to get into that situation that they have in college football where you have to pound a team, you know, down and beat them by 30 points in order to rise in the rankings. But they won convincingly, at least, and by a 20-point margin. And most of all, when you win these big games, there's no doubt about it, it helps. You go up far in the rankings, and they're just going to keep going up farther. And they can continue this consistently throughout the season, which they've done so far throughout that Thanksgiving tournament, which was a big help to get their game plan going smooth throughout the game. If they can continue that, they'll stay up there in the top notch of the state.
Morrison now with 13 points. That's his first point from someplace other than behind the three-point arc. Davis comes down with the rebound, and you know, likewise, as LT came in with a 14th ranking, Proviso West came in with a number 16 ranking, and I really think that, you know, Proviso West came in as one of the big favorites in the West Suburban Silver, and that I think that this game really puts LT in a good position to come away with maybe a conference championship this year. So one minute, 30 seconds are left. And by the way, Mike Warkentine just fouled out of the game, and he got a nice hand from the crowd. And another good performance turned in. He finished the game with 10 points. And so, as I was saying, likewise, as LT came in with the number 14 ranking, Proviso West was number 16. What do you think, Sean, is that going to do to their ranking if they
can't pick up the victory? I don't think they're going to go down far, because everybody knows this is still a good team regardless. They were on the Lions' court. The Lions had the home court advantage, so that might have played a little factor, but definitely the Lions won it. Even if they played at Proviso West, they played a good enough game to win it wherever the site was going to be. But I don't think they're going to go down far, because this is still a good team that is capable of going far throughout the season. But when you mention the Lions now, if they could win the conference, the only question is, you see every game, night in and night out, those starters play the majority of the ball game. It'll be interesting to see if they could last throughout the season. They're good athletes, but if they might tire down a little bit, you know, towards the end of the season, if we could find some easy games and get some nice rest for them, that would help.
Yeah, it was a similar situation last year when Scott Kohler and I believe it was Steve Davis went down with injuries, and LT had trouble recovering from that, and so hopefully LT will be able to avoid the injury bug this season. And there's the pass deflected. LT will have possession. 1 minute and 1 second remain as LT tries to hang on to this and pull out this victory. It's a 13-point lead as we speak.
Proviso West never really got knocked out of this game entirely. They've hung around there about a 13-point ball game, but you'd expect something more out of them for a closer game. But I just think offensively, the way they handle themselves, going up for the alley-oops on occasions and losing the ball and being erratic at times, that's what took them away from this ball game.
Mike Stemack has checked in for the Lions, replacing Graham Alexa. So Stemack making his first appearance of the game. Now Korinsky just tries to kill some clock here. Davis controls in the right wing. Now Korinsky at the free throw line. Davis Kurinski now. There's Mike Stemack, works off a Davis screen, controls in the corner. 35 seconds now left. Steve Lidke gives to Chris Kurinski, top of the key. 30 seconds and the fans sense victory for LT, and I believe they know how big of a victory this is, and that might be an intentional foul on Luane Vaughn as Steve Lidke is hoping that the call will be.
Well, you have to like the performance of Lidke all night long. The scoring is great. You'd like to have that, but you don't want to really rely on the stats number. But game-wise, he was prepared. He came out here. He had tenacity on defense, and he's ready to step up to another level offensively to go to match up against the defensive pressure that they put on. You just have to give him great credit for the way he handled himself against the brothers, Luane Vaughn and Dwayne Vaughn, throughout the night. They've come at him relentless defensive pressure. They've been clawing at him throughout the whole ball game.
Lidke has 30 points in the game, including 6 free throws in a row. One of the biggest outbursts that an LT player has had in a long time. Dwayne Vaughn for 3. He connects with 18 seconds left. So 10 seconds now are left, and Morrison's not going to let it end here. He picks up his 4th foul, and the fans are just about set to leave the North Campus Fieldhouse now. 11 seconds left to 59-47 lead for LT. So the 12-point advantage, not by any means the largest that LT has had, but more than sufficient for LT to hopefully pick up this victory.
And it's a high number total there, near 60 points already against the Proviso West defense. That's very quick. Now Proviso West coming with their players off the bench to get some playing duty.
You know, if you look at where these teams stood offensively last year, Proviso West averaged 56 points a game. So now the action resumes. 5 seconds left. So the last basket of the game, 2 seconds, and the time will run out. Another big victory for the Lions. It finishes at 59-49, and we'll be back with post-game analysis right after this.
Alcoholics, who are they and what is it? Many people have questions about this disease, and many may be wondering if they are one. For those of you who think you might be one, here are a few questions. This is called the CAGE assessment. C. Have you ever felt you should cut down on your drinking? A. Have people annoyed you by criticizing you about your drinking? G. Have you ever felt bad or guilty about your drinking? And E. Have you ever taken a drink in the morning as an eye-opener? If you said yes to one or more of these, there is a chance you could be one. For some, they must hit bottom before they realize what they're in. For information on how to contact your local Al-Anon group, write to P.O. Box 862, Midtown Station, New York, New York, 10018-0862, or call toll-free 1-800-356-9996. Call or in the end, this could be you and your family.
Hello and welcome back to the North Campus Fieldhouse after the Lions defeat the Proviso West Panthers by 10 points. And what a game it was, especially from Steve Lidke.
Steve Lidke has been just awesome, if I could use the word. The kid, scoring-wise, he's brought his game to another level. He's hit his jumpers when he had to. He's gone strong through the lane. He's hit his free throws when he had to. And defensively, which is Ron Nikovich wants the importance of some defensive ball game, he came relentless. He was straight up there. Good defense.
And so the big win pushes the Lions' record to 5-1. The Proviso West Panthers fall to 5-1 as well. And so the Lions will move on in their schedule and try to pick up another victory in the West Suburban Conference Silver. We'll be back with the statistics right after this.
Teenagers all have problems. You're not alone. Dear Mom, I feel as if I'm useless. I'm sorry it must end like this. Love always. Help is available. Suicide is not the answer. Call the suicide prevention number. Area code 312-996-5535.
Hello and once again back to the North Campus Fieldhouse here after LT defeats Proviso West by 10. Steve Lidke again with 30 points led all LT scorers and with one of the most impressive performances turned in by a Lion in many games. Mike Workenstein and Chris Kerensky were each in double figures with 10 points, and Mark Wojtowicz added 4. Dennis Carroll had 3, and Steve Davis in the middle only had 2, but he was really a defensive presence. As you see, the director of Lion Country Basketball is Dan Tomaszewski. Tonight's cameras were provided by Josh McFadden, Nick Roach, and Mike Strecker, along with KK Mallory. The executive producer of Lion Country Basketball is John Wiesmith, and we'd like to thank you for joining us here on Lion Country Basketball.